Hello and welcome to PDFSupply.com. Today we're going to be testing an IC693 MDL740. This is a 12 to 24 volt DC positive logic 16 point discrete output, digital output. Okay, so what we're going to talk about is how to test this module, a little bit about the devices that you'll need in order to test it, and how to configure it in Prophecy Machine Edition. So to start, I have everything in an IC693 CHS397 5 slot rack. You're welcome to use a 10 slot rack if that's what you have. That's what I'm using for this test. It's being powered by an IC693 PWR330 power supply. And the processor is an IC693 CPU374 Plus. Now, if you look to the right hand side of your screen, I have a 24 volt DC power supply, which is giving power to my positive terminals, which are 1 and 11, and my negative terminals, which are 10 and 20. You can see I have them jumpered here. According to the wiring diagram, positive is your 1 and 11 terminals, and negative is your 10 and 20 terminals. Okay. Now, in Prophecy Machine Edition, what I'm going to do is start a new open fresh file. And I'm going to start by selecting under my main rack, under navigator bar, a CHS397 5 slot rack, PWR330 power supply, and a CPU374 processor. And in slot number 2, we're going to be doing the IC693 MDL740, this module that's in question here. All right, so everything that I have physically in front of you, I now have in Prophecy Machine Edition. So what I'm going to do is click the toggle online button, which is the icon that looks like a lightning bolt. I'm going to go online with it. You can see we're blinking here. All right. Now once I'm connected up to it, I'm going to hit the green handprint, which puts us in programmer mode. We'll click that. All right. Next thing is I'm going to go to target. In the drop-down menu, I'm going to go about halfway down to online commands and select clear, and a clear window, a clear memory window will pop open. And you want to select the bottom two selections, which is controller fault table and IO fault table. We're going to go ahead and clear those. Don't select all memory or anything else that you may potentially lose. This is just a simple test on this output module, and all we're doing is clearing any faults that were previously in the processor so that we can get it into run mode. Next thing is, in order to get it in run mode, we're going to hit the download and start active target button, which is where it looks like downloading information with a green arrow pointing down and a run button in one. And it's going to tell you that the build is now in progress. So it's going to start to configure what this physical configuration here. And then it's going to ask you what you want to download to the controller. In this particular case, we want to download hardware configuration and motion and logic. So that's the top two selections. We're going to leave everything else out, and we're not going to write anything to the permanent flash memory. So again, just the top two selections, select OK. And then the build will finish. When it is complete, it's going to ask you if you want to enable your outputs. And then that'll allow us to get into run mode. That's coming up right now. Start controller, outputs enabled, yes. Okay, so now we're in run mode. That means that the configuration that's here physically matches what's in the Prophecy Machine Edition software, and it agrees with it, and it's good to go. So next thing is the test, of course. In order to do the test, what I would suggest, if you don't already know, is go to slot number 2 and double click it, or you could right click and select configure. And a tab will pop open that says 0.2 or slot number 2 location, and it's going to have parameters. In the parameters, you want to find out what your reference address is. Since this is a new file, mine is going to be %Q, which means output, 00001. And that's the location that I want to start to toggle my bits on. Once I know my location and the address, I'm going to go down to default tables, which is under reference view tables, and I'm going to expand that. and double click on output. And on the top right hand corner is where %Q00001 is, and that's where I'm going to start to put in my bits to toggle them from a 0 to a 1 in order to turn my outputs on. As you can see on the module, all of the outputs are turning on as I'm turning them on. So this would be a good time to tell you that the first thing is, just because the LED lights up and it says that, you know, for user reference, these channels are on, doesn't necessarily mean that they're working. It could state that it's on, but not actually have any power going to it. So we want to do an actual physical test. All right. What I have here is a solenoid or a relay. It's powered by 24 volts. Has a positive and negative lead coming off of it. And those positive and negative leads I have attached to these two probes, positive and negative. Now, since this is a positive logic, what I'm going to do is I'm going to plant my negative probe to the negative lead from my power supply, which is on. And I'm going to go through all the corresponding terminals to the channels, which starting with the first channel is starting on terminal screw number 2. And if you can hear in the background, the solenoid clicking, letting me know that I've got 24 volts at all of these points. Now, if you don't have a 24 volt solenoid or relay or anything like that that can make some sort of a noise, then you could always use a light bulb. I prefer to use the solenoid because I don't have to be looking at the solenoid to know that it's clicking on and off. I can hear it, and which allows me to touch these terminals and make sure that I'm hitting them all properly. So again, you could use a light bulb if you like. You can hang one that's within view of where you're probing, but it's sometimes a little bit better functional wise to use one of these. Again, this responds to 24 volts DC. Okay, so that pretty much tests that this is working properly. The next thing I want to do, of course, is just the opposite. I want to make sure that all of my points that I've just touched, all 16 channels, can be turned off and actually stay off, because that represents the other problem. Sometimes it'll seem that you'll have a zero bit in the location, that would suggest that the point or the channel should be off, but it really isn't. So, and this is just for example, I'm going to touch my positive lead just to give you an example. If you hear one of these turn on, then obviously it's something wrong with it. It's stuck in the on position. So far these are all off. All off. Okay. So that I'm able to turn them all on, turn them all off. I don't have any false readings. I don't have any false information coming from the user reference LEDs on these A and B channels that are suggested here. Another thing, of course, is you can't see it probably through this camera, but there's a tiny F right there for fuse. So if something does go wrong and it turns out to be a fuse that's blown, this little F here will turn green. An LED will come on telling you that there is a blown fuse in either the A group of channels or the B group of channels. So that's another thing that you can look for. That's pretty much a dead giveaway. And I think that's pretty much it. That's all the problems that we normally see with these MDL-740, since they are such a simple product. If you do have a problem with one of these and you can't figure it out yourself, this is something that we do repair here quite commonly. We offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products, and same day shipping. So if that's something that you need or interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.